Yes, good evening, children. So here we can start today's class. And in the last class, we discussed about the digestion, digestive system, and the parts of digestive system. So let me give a quick revision over this chapter or these concepts. So first of all, let me ask you a question. Okay. So Meha Mahesh, are you ready? Meha Mahesh. Okay. Yes. Please unmute. So what is the name of the process of breaking down of food? What is the name of the process of breaking down of food, Meha? Meha?
Ma'am,
excuse me. Wait. Don't unmute without my permission. If you know the answer, you can raise your hand. Okay, from your gestures, I can understand. Meha? So can I pass the question? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Did you hear the question?
Yes.
Okay. So you know the answer? Do you know? Do you know? Okay. Aradhya. Aradhya. Yes. My question is, wait. Meha, listen to Aradhya. My question is, what is the name of the process of breaking down of food in our body? Aradhya?
Digestion.
Sorry, Aradhya?
Digestion.
Yes, that is the correct answer. Okay, Meha, I hope you got the answer. What is the name of that process?
Digestion.
Okay, for digestion, different organs are working together on the food. That is why they can make the food into paste form. Am I correct? Okay. Once the food becomes paste form, then only our blood can absorb the important things from the food. So our whatever it is eating, whatever the food which we are eating, that should be in a paste form. So some organs are working together as a group. Am I correct? So not only one organ, so many organs are working. Nobin Anoop, please listen. No need to open your textbook. Just listen. So many organs are working together to make the food into paste form. So I want to know which are the organs that help the food to form it into paste form. Or I can ask in another word, which are the organs that helps in the digestion? Which are the organs that helps in our digestion? Okay, so those who know the answer, please raise your hand. Okay, I can see some of them are Saint Xavier. Saint Xavier, did you hear the question, Saint Xavier? Unmute it. Yes. Question is, which are the parts of the organs in our body that helps in digestion? Saint Xavier, you raised your hand. Okay. Wait. Those Adish Nair. Adish Nair.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
Mouth, food pipe. Stomach, large intestine, small intestine, and anus.
Anus, large intestine, small intestine, and anus. Okay, these are the organs working together. Saying, you got it? Saying? Okay, so tell me, which are the organs that help us to make the food in the paste form? Saying, say it fast. Saying?
Ma'am,
yes. Tell me, which are the organs? Is it one organ that makes the food in paste form?
No.
So many organs are working. Each organ is having their own part. Isn't it? So tell me.
Yes.
Yes. Tell me, Sain.
Mouth, food pipe, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, anus.
Then one more important one.
Liver.
Liver, yes, somebody helped you. Okay, so these are there, isn't it? So we can call these all organs together as an organ system. Am I right? Organs when work together to perform a work, we can call it as organ system. So what is the name of the organ system? What is the name of the organ system of this?
Digestive system.
That is digestive system. When I tell you that time only, you have to answer it. Okay,
Adish? Ma'am.
Yes. So, what is your?
Ma'am, can you see me?
I can hear you. I can see you. Okay, so wait. So here it is the digestion, digestive system that all we discussed and the parts of the digestive organ, isn't it? Digestive system, that also we discussed it, isn't it, children? So can we move to the next topic? So first, where we are keeping, if chapatis and curries are there for the snacks or for the, or for the dinner, where you will keep first, where we will take the
mouth.
Yeah, in mouth is the entry point of our food. Am I correct?
Yes.
Am I correct? Bhagya and Meha, please switch on your videos. Not only Fatima, Ajwa. Okay, everyone should switch on your videos. Okay. So here we can say mouth is the entry point of our food. So the journey, it is a long journey, okay? Digestion of food, it is a long journey of the food. From the mouth, it starts from mouth and it will go through different organs. So are you ready to hear the story about the journey of food?
Yes.
Okay, did we start in the mouth?
Yes, ma'am.
Did I explain about it in the mouth?
Yes.
Explain. In the last class, did we explain?
Yes.
Okay, let me once again go through it. Okay, so here you can see we take food in our mouth, isn't it? So we can say it. So we can say that digestion starts in the mouth. Okay, so Neha Mary, where does the digestion start?
Mouth.
In the mouth. Okay, no doubt. Digestion starts in the mouth. Bending Paul, which is the entry point of food in our body?
Mouth.
No doubt. Okay, clear. Mute your audio. Both of you muted. So now, digestion starts in the mouth with the help of the teeth and tongue. You can see in our mouth, isn't it? So teeth, they are present. And also the tongue, isn't it? Okay. So let me ask you about, let me Gokul Krishna, see the teeth which are present in our body, are they look same?
Yeah.
No, different in size, different in appearance. Am I right? Okay.
Yes,
so there are 32 plus 4, that is 36. 36 teeth are present in an adult human body, in the mouth of an adult human body. Isn't it? For you like kids, it is less than 30. Okay. Because the flat teeth that all have to develop. Okay. So for the adults, it is 36 teeth are present in our mouth. But they are of different size, shape also. Am I right? See, if you see the picture from there itself, you can understand. The front teeth, flat, big ones, isn't it? And the one sharp teeth at the both the end. Do you have like this teeth, children? Do you have like this teeth? See, this one, it is different. Yes. Okay. And at the back side, you can see the flat teeth. Isn't it? Flat teeth. So the front teeth helps to break the food. Okay. When you get biscuits, that's and all, you will just crush using your front teeth. Am I correct? Bananas. when you eat bananas, how you will take, you will keep it in your mouth, isn't it? So first front teeth help you to cut it. After that, the back teeth, which are flat, they will help to grind that. Isn't it? Isn't it, children?
Yes.
Do you have the feel of it? Yes, isn't it?
Yes.
And if you are eating some meat, fish like that.
Ma'am.
Yes, somebody is calling. Who is that? Okay. Don't disturb after that. Okay, so here, that the teeth which are at near to that front one. See, I marked it here. Isn't it? It is a sharp teeth. So these teeth, that will help to tear the flesh off the meat. Am I correct? When you eat the chicken pieces, leg of the chicken pieces and all, these teeth will help you to tear that flesh. Yes, Ardra is showing how the style of eating chicken. Isn't it, Ardra? Okay. So this is how the teeth help to break down the food. Clear? Okay. After that is in our mouth. See, if I show you a piece of chicken leg, or a piece of mango, raw mango, or a piece of pastry. Is it okay? No, pastry is also, if I'm showing it, something will come and fill it into your mouth. What is that?
Saliva.
Saliva, a little bit, isn't it? Isn't it? Yeah, see, Aiden is closing his mouth. Don't worry, Aiden. In everybody's mouth, it will be produced. Okay, so by the sight of the food, our mouth start to produce a liquid, and the name of that liquid is saliva. Okay, the name of that liquid is saliva. Saliva, is it a water? Is it simply a water?
No.
No, it is not simply a water, liquid form. Water is also included. Water is also present in that. But it is a digestive juice. Okay, that it is a chemical. It is a digestive juice that helps to break down the food. Okay, it contains some chemicals, useful chemical, not harmful chemical, useful chemical, that it is produced by our mouth. And also, particularly, you can see an organ in front of the ear. Can you see an organ in front of the ear here? That is called salivary gland. Have you heard about it, salivary gland?
Yes.
The salivary gland produces this saliva. Salivary gland produces this saliva.
Ma'am, some disturbances.
Okay. Children, that is why I'm telling you, just mute your audio. Everyone check it whether it is mute. It is very important to keep it muted. Okay? Everyone check it and mute it. And Kalbi, I am requesting you don't unmute. Okay, from your device that disturbing sound is produced. Maybe some due to some audio problems. Okay, so here, just check it, children. Everyone, just check it in front of your ears. Just feel it in front of your ears. Just feel it here, both sides. One gland is present. Okay, one gland is present. The name of that gland is salivary gland. Okay, in front of the both of our ears, one gland. Gland means an organ. Okay, one gland is present. That is called salivary gland, and it produces Tejasri. What does it produce? Tejasri is not able to answer.
Saliva.
Yes, saliva. It produces saliva. Okay, so saliva is produced by the salivary gland, which is present in our mouth. Whenever we see, whenever our eyes send the message of some sight of some food, the salivary gland will produce saliva into our mouth. It is not our fault. It is the nature's blessing. Okay, so this saliva, is this saliva simply a liquid? Is it simply a liquid? No, it is digestive juice. Okay, it contains helpful chemicals that can break down the food. Okay, so saliva is present. And what is the function of the saliva? I will tell you. Do you like tea rusk? Tea rusk?
Yes.
All of you like tea rusk, isn't it? It is very dry and hard. Am I correct, children? It is very dry and hard. Not like biscuits. So, it is very difficult to break it by using our teeth. Am I correct? So what we will do, we will take a piece of the rusk and we'll put it in our mouth. One, Andrea, I am seeing you are frequently unmuting it. So when we are putting a piece of rusk in our mouth, what will happen? The saliva will mix with the rusk piece. Okay, the saliva will mix with the piece of rusk, and what will happen, Ishan? Can you tell me when the saliva mixes with the rusk piece in our mouth, what will happen to its dryness? What will happen to its hardness?
It will come to soft.
Yeah, that will become soft and also wet. Soft and wet. Got it? So at that time, our teeth can easily break it into pieces. It is very easy to break it into pieces at that time. Okay, so really the saliva is helping us to make the food into soft and wet. Am I correct? Okay, so Ardra, tell me, what is there in our mouth? Ardra, what is there in our mouth that makes the food soft and wet?
Saliva.
Saliva. Okay, clear? Is it clear, children? Okay.
Yes.
So, the duty of the saliva, the function of the saliva. Saliva mixes with the food and make the food soft and wet. Clear? So, saliva's function, is it over? After that, teeth. It is the role of the teeth now. Teeth help to chew the food. Once the food mixed with the saliva, it will become wet and soft. Then the teeth will do its role. Okay. What is the role of the teeth? To chew the food and break it into smaller pieces. To chew the food and break it into smaller pieces. Is it clear? Is it clear now? Okay, Dave John, unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what is there in our mouth that helps to chew the food?
Teeth.
Okay, so one more question to you, Dave. What helps in mixing the food? Sorry. What makes the food soft and wet?
Saliva.
Okay, good. Now, so the function of the teeth, it is over. Function of the saliva is also over. Now it is remaining tongue. What is the help that tongue? What is the work of the tongue? What is the role?
They will mix the head chew.
Yeah, yes, yes.
The tongue helps to mix.
Ryan, see it, children. I already told, please mute your audio and I will give chance. Okay. So I want to get, Ryan, Eunice. Yes, tell me. What is the role of the tongue now? What is the work done by the tongue?
Tongue helps to push the food into, chewed food into our food pipe.
Okay, before that, when we are eating something, our tongue is also moving, isn't
taste.
It?
Yes.
Yeah, why it is?
Till
because
taste.
It helps to mix the saliva with the food. Tongue helps to mix the saliva with the water, with the food. What it?
Yes.
So
yes.
Tongue helps to mix the saliva with our food. Muhammad Ihan?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, Isan, no? Okay, Isan, tell me, Muhammad Isan. What is there in our food that helps in mixing the food with the saliva? Mixing the food with the saliva?
Tongue.
Tongue. Okay.
Tongue.
And not only that, tongue also pushes the chewed food towards the food pipe. Using the different types of teeth, if the food get grinded, it broken into pieces, the tongue, we will swallow it. Am I correct? We will swallow that one, isn't it? See, at that, when we are swallowing, our tongue will help to push the food into the food pipe. Okay, so here ends the story of food in the mouth. Got it? And another scene. Next one is another scene. That is in the food pipe. Am I correct, children? That is in the food pipe. So here from the mouth, the food reached into the food pipe by the push of the tongue. Got it clear? Is it clear? So yeah. Here I think we can ask one question. What are the functions of our tongue? What are the functions of the tongue in the in digestion? Okay, so let me ask you, who is ready to answer that question? What are the functions of tongue in digestion? Those who know the answer, please raise it. Okay, I can. Jovial Suraj, Jovial, please tell me, what are the functions of tongue in digestion?
The tongue will help the saliva to mix with the food.
Very good, very good. Okay, enough, Jovial. I got one, this one function. Another function, who will say? Cassina Salil. Yes, Cassina.
Ma'am, yes. It moves the food into the food pipe.
It pushes the food into the food pipe. Very good. Rahul Krishna, so can we see what it happens in food? Happens that a chewed food in the food pipe? Do you want to know?
Yes.
You want to know?
Yes.
Okay. So yes. Here. Okay. 1 minute. So here. It reached into the food pipe. You can see this food pipe, isn't it? It is a long tube. Food pipe means it is a long, narrow tube. It is about 25 centimeter long. Okay, it is about 25 centimeter. So I will tell you, do you have the scale with you, children? Do you have scale? Please take it. Scales. Yes, yes, sir, please. Okay, Dave, John is showing that scale. Okay, Dave. Okay, there you can see so many are having this one. Can you see 25 centimeter there? 0 to 25 centimeter?
No.
0, yes. 1, 2, 25?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Up to
yes.
25, you just, yes, yeah. Asra,
only
is
50.
It?
Only 50.
Only 15. Okay, those are having 15. Please keep it down. Those are having 25. Please show it. Show me that 25. Bending pole 25. Okay. So I will keep the spotlight for everyone. Bending. Okay. 25. Okay. Keep it in a standing position. Keep it in a stand. Zero on the top. Zero on the top. Zero on the top.
And I have. That. I have.
Wait,
I got.
Wait. Show the 25. Okay. So 0 to 25. This much is there.
Yes.
I think it is upside 25. Okay. So this much length. So show it from the
30.
Top. Yeah, that is 0 to 25 centimeter. That much length is for our food pipe. Understood, children? That much length is there for the food pipe. Got it? Huh? How much big it is, isn't it? So, what is the length of our food pipe? If you are checking, you can see by keeping it here to here, it is 25. Really? Isn't it, Bendik? Yeah. So, check it after the class. Okay. So, this much is the length of our food pipe. And this food pipe It connects mouth and to the stomach. Food pipe moves the food from the back of our throat to our stomach. Okay, so it is connecting the mouth and the food pipe. Sorry, stomach. Mouth and the stomach. Aiden, what is the name of Aiden? Unmute.
Yes, ma'am.
Aiden, unmute it. Okay, tell me, what is the name of the narrow tube that connects the mouth and the stomach?
Ma'am, food pipe.
Okay, stomach. So I hope it is clear, children. Okay, due to the movement of the muscles inside the food pipe, the food which it is chewed, pushed by the tongue, it will move towards the stomach. Okay, so now the role of the food pipe is also over. Okay, so shall I move to the next one?
Yes.
That is about the stomach. Okay, it is a stretchy bag-like organ. Can you see this? It is like a bag. Isn't it? It is like a bag. So what you can say about the stomach, not from the textbook or from anywhere, just what you understand, what you know about stomach, what you feel about stomach.
Sac-like organ.
Okay, Abdiel, tell me, am I calling correct? Abdiel, is it Abdiel? Is it Abdiel?
Yes.
Okay, then Abdiel, tell me, what do you know about this stomach? Where is his position? I think yes, Abdiel, unmute. Then only we can hear.
Sac-like organ.
Sorry?
Sac-like organ.
Sac-like organ. Okay, it is a sac-like organ. Something else?
Under own.
Yeah.
Or just. Huh?
Ma'am, can I add?
Okay, Kasina. You can add some just, more points.
That's on our chest.
From the food pipe, the stomach will carry the food.
Okay, from the food pipe, it is carrying. Okay, this much only? Okay, so Rayan Eunice told me it is under the. Which
chest.
One?
Chest.
Okay. Just below the chest. Okay. Then Adish.
Ma'am, it makes the food like a mixer grinder.
Yeah, very good. It is like a mixer grinder. Do you have mixie at home?
Yes.
How it works?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, when your mother keeps the mango pieces in the mixie, what will happen? What you will get?
It will become into juice.
Isn't it? Yeah. So what will happen to the food? Yes. What will happen to the food when it comes to the stomach? We will learn it in the next class. That story, we will learn it in the next class.